Well, today is June 13th. I'm sitting here with Thomas Tompkins at the Medicos Rehab Center. Tom, could you tell us what brought you to Germany and report a little bit about your last 10 days of your stay here?
Sure. Well, what brought me to Germany is I was in a car accident in 24 years ago in 1994. And I didn't know it at the time, but that shear force, a car hit me from the side, and that shear force in my spine caused my disc to start degenerating. And about 2 weeks after that, I threw my back out for the first time. And after that, it just started to become more and more frequent, where I'd throw my back out like every few months. And it got to the point where I was starting to have many more bad days than I were good days. And 24 years I struggled with this. I tried many different conservative treatments. I tried many different chiropractors. In 2006, I was actually hospitalized for 5 days. That's when I first found out that I had bulging and herniated discs. And that's also when I found out that in the United States, they don't do anything to fix that. They just kept giving me more and more drugs. And they said as soon as I could stand up and walk out of the hospital, then that was it. And so that was the day that I learned that the doctors really don't do anything for you over there. And you're kind of on your own. And after that, I've tried many different physical therapy programs, which some of them helped somewhat, but every time I started to get better, there was a very short period of time, and then I'd fall right back into where I was. And it was just this cycle of constantly, not being able to move, and then getting a little bit better, and then, you know, months and months of not being able to move again. And just over time, it got worse and worse. And I heard about artificial disc replacement. I went to a surgeon in 2012, hoping that there would be something that they could do. And at the time, I was looking at discectomies and microdiscectomies. And one of the best back surgeons in Minnesota, he told me that he took one look at my MRI and he said, "I'm sorry, but there's nothing I can do for you other than a fusion." He said I wasn't a candidate for a discectomy. He said it wouldn't do anything for me. My discs were too far gone, which by the way is L3-4 and L4-5. And at the time he brought up Germany as a possible option for artificial disc replacement. And I thought it was a crazy idea to want to go to Germany to have this done. But he basically told me that his hands were tied and that the FDA doesn't allow multiple disc replacements on the lower lumbar spine. And at the time, I didn't want to have that type of surgery. And so I just kind of shook his hand and thanked him for his time. And I went on with my life thinking that there really wasn't an option for me. And this last year, things started getting worse and worse. And I getting out of bed in the morning was a long, drawn-out process. I had to slide out of the bed onto the floor and basically crawl on the floor and get up on a walker and just to get to the bathroom. So the first couple hours of every single day of my life was me trying to get around on a walker. And, you know, my kids seeing that, it just, you know, it just wasn't right. And so the last few months, I really started to do a deep dive into my research. And I talked to a lot of people on various different Facebook groups and other places that have actually had artificial disc replacement in Germany, and not just in Germany, but in other places in the world. And the success stories that I was seeing were just amazing to me. So I gave it a closer look, and I found out about Dr. Bierstedt with ONZ, and we learned about the Medicos rehabilitation program that they offer along with the surgery, and we decided that this was the best place that we could come for the surgery. And I have to admit, my expectations weren't really all that high. I expected to have a lot more pain. I just had my surgery was just a week and a day ago, 7 days ago, or 8 days ago. And I all of my back pain and all of my leg, I had sciatic pain that would go all the way down to my foot. All of that pain is 100% completely gone. And the only pain that I have is a little bit of incision pain where they cut me open to do the surgery. And I am just completely amazed about how I feel. I'm completely amazed and impressed with the entire process with ONZ. There's a driver that comes and picks you up from the airport and delivers you where you need to go. At the entire nursing staff at the hospital was completely amazing. I haven't received that quality of care in the United States. Just every aspect of the entire program, not only myself, but there was three other surgery mates that had surgery on the same day that I did. And so we've been going through this entire process together, and every person in our group has just been completely amazed at this entire process in ONZ. So we are entirely thankful that this is even a possibility here in Germany. So,
do you recommend it to anyone else?
Oh, definitely, absolutely. If people have been struggling with back pain for a number of years and have tried all of the conservative treatments that you're supposed to try, and they're still not getting anywhere with it, I would absolutely recommend to send in your files to ONZ, have them do an evaluation, and if you're a candidate for artificial disc replacement, I would say go for it. It is totally worth the money and then some. Now, when I get back to the United States, I'm gonna be able to play with my kids.
What did you do last night?
Last night, on my 1 week anniversary from being strapped down to the surgery table, I went to the Guns N' Roses concert, which is in the stadium right across from Medicos. Just amazing.